We're in Hamburg in Germany at Shell's Research and Development Center. You may not be aware of this, but all the cars in the Le Mans 24 hours have the same fuel supplier, Shell. This year, there's a lot at stake for the petrol company's laboratory, as all the cars have to reduce their fuel consumption by 30%.
Hello.
Very nice to meet you. Hello.
Thank you.
Warm welcome to you.
The aim is a 30% reduction. So how can the fuel contribute to this?
The 30% target in terms of improving efficiency or reducing the consumption, that's a combination out of three things. On the one side, the fuel properties. We are searching for new fuel properties and new components. But also then the enabling a new engine design through the fuel properties. So it's like fuel co-engineering on that side. And the third point is the energy recovery systems and the storage systems.
Laboratory for all fuels development, for race fuels, for Formula One, for endurance racing.
Why has Audi opted for a diesel engine, while Porsche and Toyota have both gone the petrol route?
It's a philosophy. We need both. We know that both type of fuels are important for the transport industry, and both will have the role in the future as well.
The new regulations impose an increase in bioethanol in the fuel. By how much?
In 2014, we want to move on. We want to do the next step, and we look ahead from a road-relevant perspective, and we do expect that the biofuels play an important role in the future, and therefore we have doubled the bio content, but important to say it's all on advanced biofuel level. We do not work with regular biofuels in our racing application because we want to be a...
The Le Mans 24 Hours, a new era dawns. Pierre is going to remind us of the new rules of the game concerning fuel consumption.
This consumption is calculated on a permanent basis over each lap in real time. How? There is an allocation of fuel, petrol or diesel, which has to be respected for each lap covered. There's a slight tolerance. The drivers can make up for a mistake over the next two laps. So, they have a three-lap window to adjust their consumption. If not, they're penalized. This can just be a drive-through or a stop-and-go.
Yeah, it's very yellow and very... is it water now?
No, it looks like water, but it has a bit more energy than water.
Is it important for Shell to take part in these races? Does it improve the fuel we use every day?
Endurance racing is one of the fastest and toughest testbed for fuels and lubricants development for Shell you can have. So, for example, within a 24-hour race at Le Mans, the insights we get for our fuels and lubricants development that equals about 1 year engine dyno work here in our laboratory. That's the amount of insights we can get out of just one race.
In any case, whether it's petrol or diesel, all the fuels have to go through a fuel flow meter, which measures to a drop the consumption of all the cars. That's the subject of our next meeting.
You know, you can search the AutoChannel.com's new car buyer's guide to quickly and easily find specs, prices, multi-car comparison, and the latest news about every new passenger car and truck sold in North America. The AutoChannel.com, there's nothing else like it.